Simon & Schuster Audio presents The Believer, A Year in the Fly Fishing Life by David Coggins. Read by Scott Brick with an afterword by the author.
Some of the names have been changed. All the fishing stories are real. Introduction. A Midpoint. I'm halfway through my life. This bracing metric puts time in perspective. A clear, well-defined before giving way to a symmetrical, even poignant after. The long view no longer looks so long. I'm 45, or I was when I began this book. And it's true that I've been making this dramatic declaration for a few years now, giving the equation an interpretive flexibility, like the message you read in a fortune cookie. A good part of my life's first half has been given over to fly fishing. I learned to fish on the lake at our family's cabin in Wisconsin. Then I got serious and started driving west to the great rivers in Montana. Once arrived, I made a fool of myself, which I accepted as part of a long, even noble process. Back then, everything felt new, and I loved those road trips. The landscape, the water, the trout, the dive bars, the sense of freedom. Discovering the world comes easy when you're young and don't mind sleeping in motels where the television is chained to the wall. Getting older turns out to come as a surprise, which is mildly embarrassing. My beard has turned many shades of gray, and I've started to discover wayward eyebrows that I used to associate with Scotsmen striding the heath with their deerhounds. I'm shocked that the paper edition of the New York Times no longer costs a quarter. It's now $4, as it happens. I remember when phones had cords, planes had ashtrays, and fax machines were an object of fascination. Though, to me, they still are. But it's more than that. I feel a sense of my own obsolescence. My favorite bars are now closed. My favorite bands now disbanded. Most of my friends have left Manhattan. They discuss prestigious preschools. One bought a lawnmower. This all feels very adult. I'm not among the ranks of homeowners myself. In fact, until recently, my apartment had one closet. I still set aside time to fish. Some might say a lot of time. Occasionally, I meet a person who finds my fishing obsession interesting. In my experience, this doesn't last long. That's particularly true when it comes to matters of the heart. Until my darling girlfriend moved in with me, my fishing life remained a relative abstraction to her. In close quarters, however, my devotion to the piscatorial arts began to intrude upon the household harmony. How much you fish changes, like so many things, once domestic obligations enter the equation. How could it not? Fishing, which had signified an individualistic streak, now implies a lack of commitment to our shared life. If we start a family, then, well, we know how that ends. Fishing moves down the list of priorities and might be left off it entirely. Other things come into focus. I now admit that, yes, the trunk of my car could function as more than my own exclusive fishing storage. It's been devoted to angling essentials for so long, I forgot it could be used for anything else. I've also reassessed why I go fishing in the Bahamas with men my father's age, instead of relaxing on the beach with somebody I'd actually like to see in a bathing suit. Angling, considered in this light, is no longer seen in the independent Thoreauvian tradition. It might possibly, looked at in a certain way, be considered a distraction. But a distraction from what? That fishing is secretly the primary focus and everything else is a distraction does not go over well at the dinner table. So I've been thinking about time. When you have a lot of time, it's not something you think much about. When you realize there's less time, things unfortunately start to move more quickly. Fishing has a specific relationship to time. For many of us, the sport operates in opposition to our so-called real lives. Quarterly tax payments. Did I remember to pay those? Meetings, interviews, what makes us, in theory, productive members of society. To fish properly, you need time. Money helps. But you can get around that if you're strategic. Time is the thing. And there's no way to avoid the friction that fishing seriously means you're leaving people behind while you're on the water. People who, when you go salmon fishing in the snow, think you've possibly lost your mind. That fishing exists outside professional duties recommends it. While fishing, I can for a time ignore deadlines, conference calls, and fandom of my tragic sports teams. I am, in the best sense, out of reception. Except I'm more connected to what's around me. The shadows on the water, the speed of the clouds, the changing of the light than at any other time. Fishing, if we allow it, becomes an antidote to the modern world's focus on the collective present moment. We are updated on developing stories, held hostage to the scroll, the chyron, the feed, the notifications. Everything is endlessly suspended in real time, and there's no chance to reflect. Nobody gets their news from the newspaper anymore, even for $4. Once it's printed, something else is already happening. Forget writing a letter, you might as well start a fire with two sticks. When you travel to fish, this changes the equation. The first thing to do is establish an advance position on the calendar. Wear something three times and it becomes what the fashion rags call a signature look. All white, nautical stripes, a novel hat, whether it's good or bad, people will recognize it. Similarly, the angler must stake out his territory. Go to Patagonia in January once and people think it's indulgent. Ignore them. The second time they come to terms with it, the third time they expect it. They know you fly to Buenos Aires after New Year's. This is your thing, and they may roll their eyes, but they know you're unavailable for dinner parties and christenings. While loved ones must be briefed on your long-term plans, fishing remains to a large degree a secret life. Actors, athletes, mayors, marines, short-order cooks, high-stakes gamblers, priests. These professions can only be understood when you're on the inside. Only another actor will ever understand the humiliation of forgetting your lines on stage. We're not winning Tony Awards here, but only another angler can truly appreciate the joy of catching a 2-foot trout on a blue wing olive, a fly smaller than a chocolate chip. Or, conversely, the pain of losing an Atlantic salmon that you've fought all the way to the shore before it snaps the leader and breaks your heart. Yes, angling can become a full life, and a way to measure a life. The seasons, the years, the people you've fished with, those who patiently taught you, who have moved on to the trout stream in the sky. Now, to your surprise, you are the one who teaches other people. You hear truisms, as far as there are truisms in angling, pour from your mouth as you look upon your charges. Rod tip up, you yell, when they have a fish on the line. Keep the pressure on, you bellow, like a raving lunatic. This all subsides in a wave of euphoria when they succeed. I have, to my surprise, gotten misty-eyed when friends have, with my help, caught their first fish on a fly. Is this because I want them to be happy? Because I want them to understand in some small way what's hijacked my life? I don't know. Somebody yelling how to land a fish is not part of the platonic ideal of the sport, but the undiluted smile on their face when they've landed their first trout sure is. At some point, you ask how you ended up here. I'm not sure if this happens to deadheads at their 100th show, Or if people ask why they're in the front row at WrestleMania with their face painted. You made some decisions way back when, and they stuck. You had a chance to take the off-ramp, but you kept going. You made it to Las Vegas and placed the big bet. Now you're on the far side of the world trying to get a trout to take a fly. And if it doesn't, you might melt down. Catch the fish and you're a genius. And if you don't, you ask...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.